Hi everyone, my name is Khalid Shoshi, PhD student from Faculty of Science and Techniques of Tangier. It's my pleasure today to present on behalf of my supervisors, Professor Werdous and Professor Barnoussi, our paper entitled Standard Energy Renovation at the Urban Scale in the Moroccan Context. So here is an outline of my presentation today. Firstly, I will start with an introduction, then I will present a summary of literature review and I introduce the problem approach and study zone. Finally, we'll finish with results and conclusions. In the Moroccan context, the public authorities have set up a proactive national energy strategy to support strong economic growth within a sustainable development framework. Given that the country improved over 90% of its energy needs. The main objective of the national strategy is therefore to reduce this heavy energy dependency on imports by achieving 50% energy saving by 2030. In the last 50 years, the urbanization rate has reached 63.9%. Population growth and urban sprawl have led to increase in energy consumption, which is up by 33% in the sector. Faced with this challenge, the construction sector alone can attain energy saving of up to 40%. So the problem is newly constructed buildings account for annual rates of 2% for the entire building stock, indicating that the renewal of all existing buildings will take roughly 50 or 100 years or more. This implies that the current building stock will continue to be part of the urban construction environment for decades. This work is motivated by the considerable lack of large-scale urban energy renovation strategies within the country's energy policies. Consequently, it is necessary to support decision-making process in terms of energy planning at the urban scale. So the objectives of this research is to explore answers for the following questions. How can one evaluate the impact of large-scale energy retrofit strategies on heating and air conditioning demand? What savings should be expected in scenario of renovation based on the Moroccan thermal construction regulation? So, in this research, the literature review has shown that the majority of works related to energy retrofit in Morocco are concerned with the individual building level, and that there is a significant lack of studies evaluating energy retrofit at a large scale based on the RTCM regulations. Other things, the energy efficiency measures that were most popular are thermal insulation and orientation of building envelope and outdoor shading. The fourth point is there are three main software suites that were used: TRNSS, Pinayet, and Design Builder. In other side, urban energy retrofit strategies can be categorized by the energy modeling approach that is used, top-down or bottom-up method, and by the nature of the models, physical or statistical. This is due to the fact that energy modeling is an essential tool that is shared by most energy-related studies for renovation, building integration, energy planning, or for comparative studies. So the main contribution of this research is to propose a methodological framework for the evaluation of energy retrofit strategies, not only at the single building scale, but on the urban scale, with performing a simple energy simulation using the BinAid software, which was designed to respect RTCM standards, as well as using the GIS tool to extrapolate the results of the whole study zone. On the other hand, the model proposed a simple performance indicator to evaluate the impact and energy gains that can be saved in a large-scale energy retrofit strategy. The proposed methodological framework is based on a bottom-up approach in a multi-scale GIS environment. It combines physical and statistical methods to split up the building stock market into different archetypes. In our workflow, the methodology that is used comprises four main phases. Each phase is divided into a number of steps to be performed. The specifics of each step are detailed in the following slide. In the first step is data collection. This phase consists mainly of gathering data of various type, geometric or not geometric, about the building stock from various sources. This data will then be stored in a geographic database that is supported by a GIS software that is simplified the bottom-up mapping of the results at the end of the process. Data processing, this step allows one to filter, classify and improve the quality of the collected data by detecting outlier and anomalies. Similarly, it allows one to extract the implicit information that is behind the raw data of the building stock. In this slide, we have three steps. Segmentation of building stock. The goal of this step is to group the buildings into the same class when they are as similar as possible using the clustering method. This class summarizes similar buildings into a single representative building named archetypes, and they collectively represent the characteristics of the whole building stock. In characterization phase, we define the construction materials and the thermodynamics parameters of the parts constituting the envelopes of the building stock. For that, we define the U values of each component of the envelope from the thermal conductivities of each construction material. Next step is quantification. The goal of this phase is to analyze the distribution of the structural and dimensional characteristics of the archetype throughout the study zone. The data in GIS database is processed using queries and the spatial analysis to classify each building according to its corresponding archetype. Energy simulations at the urban scale are performed through simulation of the representative archetypes of building stock. This considerably reduces the modeling and simulation time required for each individual building, simulating a few dozen archetypes instead of 1,000 buildings seems like a good cost-saving solution. Different thermal simulation software can be used for evaluation of energy performance of buildings. In fact, to adapt as much as possible to the Moroccan context of the study, the energy simulations of the archetypes are performed using local software BinAid. In this slide, we present the Moroccan thermal regulation. The decree of Moroccan thermal construction regulation was improved in 2050, so buildings have to respect minimum efficiency and performance thresholds according to their geographic location to achieve the following objectives: reduce heating and air conditioning requirements, improve thermal comfort, reduce the national energy bill, and reduce the greenhouse gas emissions. In order to build this RTCM regulation, a subdivision of Moroccan territory into six climatic zones is realized on the basis of the analysis of climatic data recorded by 37 meteorological stations. This table and map shows the minimum thermal specification to be respected for the six zones. So the next step is energy assessment. The objective of this phase is to evaluate the impact of the energy performance on heating and cooling needs of the building stock, the energy saving gained by implementing the standard renovation scenario RTCM on the urban scale can be calculated by the following ratio. The gain equals the difference between a current state energy needs and energy needs after the RTCM compliance renovation scenario divided by current state energy needs. So the estimated energy gain can be used as a performance indicator when making large-scale energy retrofit projects. It allows one to recognize the most suitable energy efficiency measures and evaluate the different large-scale retrofit strategies. And the last step, mapping energy renovation scenarios of the old building stock can represent a valuable tool for stakeholders in energy planning studies and a tool to encourage citizens to join to the energy renovation process. So this is our study zone. To demonstrate the applicability of the proposed methodological framework and its implementation, the case study was performed in the Bouzghalal district, located to the north of Madiq city in the north of Morocco, classified in the second climate zone Z2. The proposed approach has been applied to the modern Moroccan dwelling. So for the segmentation of the districts, after we used the Kamins method, the results of clustering are summarized in the following figure. So we can see four archetypes that summarize the whole district. The previously 3D modeled archetypes are used as inputs for the energy simulation in Binayet software. The simulation of heating and air conditioning needs of each archetype building are summarized in this table. So the right map represents the generalization of the four archetypes using the GIS over the entire district to calculate its annual energy demand. In this slide, we present the results of spatial distribution of calculated energy demand for the study zone. We can see three maps. The first is the spatial distribution of heating energy needs. The second represents the distribution of cooling energy needs. And the third is the sum of both. The results of the energy balance calculation show that the heating demand is higher than the cooling. And this means that savings can be made in heating more than in cooling. In this slide, we present the results of the evaluation that was performed on the impact of implementing the RTCM thermal regulation on heating cooling requirements in the districts. Then we can see two maps. The first one represents current energy needs and the second represent the energy needs after the RTCM compliant retrofit scenario. The total energy savings of each building and the energy that can be saved for the district equals the difference between the two maps. So the main results of implementing the RTCM through an energy retrofit scenario at the scale of the study zone leads to a significant reduction in heating cooling requirements, with the total annual savings of 52.72% relative to the current situation. To conclude this presentation, public authorities need a simple approach, operational methods, and flexible tools to simplify the identification and evaluation of the scope of energy efficiency. In this research, we proposed a methodological framework to support decision-making process in terms of energy planning at the urban scale by evaluating the impact of energy innovation strategies on heating and air condition demand. The methodological framework is based on a bottom-up approach in multi-scale GIS environments. It combines physical and statistical methods to divide the set of buildings into different archetypes. The results of the simulation are then generalized and extrapolates on the entire set of buildings using the GIS tools. Calculates the estimated energy savings can be used as a performance indicator for the evaluation of different renovation strategies and the implementation of an RTCM-based energy retrofit scenario on the district scale has achieved significant energy savings of up to 52.72%. So the future research will pertain to the application of the study to all districts of the Mediq city with an energetic analysis of other building typologies. That's the end of our presentation. Thank you for your attention.